Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to St. Rose of Lima Church. As we begin our celebration, if you are able, please stand and join in singing our gathering hymn, number 578, How Great Thou Art, 578.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray.
O God, who through your word reconciled the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the second book of Chronicles. In those days, all the princes of Judah, the priests, and the people added infidelity to infidelity, practicing all the abominations of the nations and polluting the Lord's temple, which he had consecrated in Jerusalem. Early and often did the Lord, the God of their fathers, send his messengers to them, for he had compassion on his people and his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God, despised his warnings, and scoffed at his prophets, until the anger of the Lord against his people was so inflamed that there was no remedy. Their enemies burned the house of God, tore down the walls of Jerusalem, set all its palaces afire, and destroyed all its precious objects. Those who escaped the sword were carried captive to Babylon, where they became servants of the king of the Chaldeans and his sons, until the kingdom of the Persians came to power. All this was to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah. Until the land has retrieved its lost Sabbaths, during all the time it lies waste, it shall have rest, while 70 years are fulfilled. In the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah, the Lord inspired King Cyrus of Persia to issue this proclamation throughout his kingdom, both by word of mouth and in writing. Thus says Cyrus, king of Persia, all the kingdoms of the earth, the Lord, the God of heaven, has given to me, and he has also charged me to build him a house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Whoever, therefore, among you belongs to any part of his people, let him go up, and may his God be with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, God, who is rich in mercy because of the great love he had for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved, raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you, it is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for the good works that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite our first communion class, our children, to come in church here up front. Well, in fact, any child in the church is welcome to come here to the front. retreat this afternoon.
Good.
Yes, awesome. So, I just got a question. Can you repeat the question you just said?
Why are you wearing pink?
Okay. What was the color I was supposed to be wearing?
Purple.
Yes, so the Lenten season is the season in which the color of the vestment is purple. Actually, our altar is purple, and we have some decorations in the church that are purple. But today is a special Sunday, and this is Sunday. This Sunday is called the Letare Sunday. Can you repeat that after me? Letare Sunday. And Letare Sunday just means a Sunday to rejoice. It's a Sunday to rejoice. And because it's a Sunday to rejoice, then the church said, let's change the color purple to rose or pink to symbolize that we are rejoicing. And we are rejoicing because Letare Sunday is a Sunday, the theme of Letare Sunday, especially with the readings we had today, is gifts. That's the theme of the Letare Sunday. So, I have here a gift that I received. Can you think of the best gift you've ever received? And just shout out.
Love.
Love, great. Gift, puppy? What's the name of your puppy? Burley?
Barley.
Wow. A rabbit. Look at that beautiful stuffed rabbit. Awesome. What else? What other great gifts have you received?
Candy.
Love. Another love. Wonderful. What else? A trampoline. Ooh, that's a fun gift. What other great gifts you've received? A swing. That's cool. Family. McDonald's. A big McDonald's. When I was growing up in Colombia, going to McDonald's was a very nice treat, and they used to have a lot of games and playgrounds for kids. So back then, long time ago, in Colombia, it was a great gift to go to McDonald's. I received great gifts too. I remember my very first bike, and it had the most awesome training wheels because I needed training wheels. And I loved my bike. It was like the sky was white and blue, so it looked like it had clouds in it. It was an amazing bike. I've got some other very nice gifts, my birthdays and Christmas time. Of many, many great gifts that I received. Yes. What is inside the gift? This is actually a gift that somebody brought me from a trip. So this person went to Rome, where, do you know where who lives in Rome that we pray for at every Mass?
Jesus.
Well, Jesus lives everywhere. He lives here. At every Mass, we say the name of this person who lives in Rome. Yes, the Pope. And what's the name of the Pope?
They said no.
Pope Francis? Pope Francis, yes. So I had a friend who went to Rome and went to visit some of the churches in Rome and got me this gift that it's a very beautiful. What is this?
A cross necklace.
Any other guess?
Rosary beads.
Yes, rosary beads. So I pray the rosary. So this is very pretty, very nice. So it's a gift.
What's a rosary?
So rosary is a prayer that is very special because it's a prayer to God through Mary. Mary, the Virgin Mary, the Mother of Jesus, and our spiritual Mother in Heaven. And so I use this great gift to pray the rosary. Now, I mentioned that today's theme is a gift, and that's the theme of today because St. Paul in the second reading talks about a gift we have received. And that gift is faith. We have received the gift of faith. And then in the Gospel, St. John says something amazing about the most amazing gift ever. And that gift is that God so loved the world that he sent his Son into the world so that we might have life eternal. So God gave us who?
Jesus.
God gave us Jesus as the most amazing gift. And just in a few weeks, you are going to be celebrating a beautiful sacrament. What sacrament is that?
First communion.
Yes, you're going to be receiving the first communion, the sacrament of communion. And when you receive communion, what are you receiving? Yes.
The holy bread
and the precious wine. And what is that? Is it like any other bread you eat?
No.
It's special bread.
It's special because it's holy and it's what? Yes, it's Jesus himself. It's Jesus himself that becomes bread. So Jesus becomes bread, he becomes wine so that we can consume and he can come and live in our hearts. And that's the greatest gift that God has given us. What other gifts God gives us? Yes.
Faith.
Yes. What else? Family. Life. Yes. Yes. No, because Jesus becomes a bread. And so it is bread, but it's he who becomes bread. Yes. Yes. Food and shelter over our head. What else? He gives us so much love. And so we can think of so many different gifts that God gives us all the time. But in a very special way, when that bread that is blessed in church and that wine that is blessed in church become Jesus, we are receiving the greatest gift that God has ever given us. And so you're preparing your hearts for that. We are all praying for you and we rejoice for you for your first communion and every time you receive communion. And so we give thanks to God for all the gifts and especially the gift of Jesus. Yes.
That when Jesus becomes bread,
it is actually Jesus. So Jesus is the Son of God. So he has the power to do everything. Whatever he wants, he's God, right? And so he becomes, and this is a miracle. It's a miracle that he becomes bread so that we may be able to receive him in our very hearts and in our souls. So Jesus is the Eucharist. Yes, Jesus is the bread. So he comes to dwell in our souls. And you guys are turning very theological today. Talking about very deep theological questions. So we're going to continue with the Mass. But if you have any other questions, I'll be very happy to answer those questions after Mass or any other time. So you can go back now to your families. And now let us stand as we profess our faith. As I mentioned at the beginning of Mass, we'll be reciting the Apostles' Creed that you can find in the Mass. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who
was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He ascended to hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Place in our hearts the love and mercy of God, who has given us the gift of faith. Let us lift up our prayers and intentions.
For the Church, that we may continue to grow in our relationship with Christ and manifest God's unbounded love for the human family by our deeds of light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, for all who lead and guide us, may this holy season restore and renew their spirit of holiness and service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, as the anniversary of his election as Pope nears, that God will sustain him in his ministry, inspire his teaching, and help him to lead the Church to greater faith and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering, that God's unending love will bring health to the sick, food to the hungry, shelter to the homeless, and jobs to the unemployed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, particularly Nancy Peretta, who died recently, and Nick Bouchet, whose funeral was celebrated this week, and especially for Anthony Melosi, for whom this Mass is being offered, may they be raised up on the last day to live forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you open our hearts with the gift of your Son. Help us to place our trust in him and to lift up our prayers and intentions through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our gifts are presented and the altars prepared, please join in singing our offertory hymn, number 645, Amazing Grace, 645.
Amen.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands and praise and glory of his name, and our good and God's holy church.
We place before you with joy these sufferings which bring eternal remedy, O Lord. Pray that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as it is fitting for the salvation of the whole world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord is to be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord and Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For your will, our self-denial should give you thanks. Humble our sinful pride. Contribute to the feeling of the poor. So help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you and countless angels as with one voice of praise we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that for the taking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope, the name of our Pope, Pope Francis, and our Bishop, what's the name of our Bishop? Robert, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially Anthony Malozzi, we remember in this Eucharist, and welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Rose of Lima, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
7:27, come to me, O weary traveler. 7:27.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who enlightens everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you in all sincerity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lenten mission is finally here, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We have a wonderful Lenten mission with the theme, With God by My Side. We're reflecting today on the gift of faith. That gift needs to be nourished and needs to grow in our hearts. So our Lenten mission is a way to nourish that gift of faith that we have received from God. Monday night at 7 p.m., we're welcoming Dr. Thomas Grun. He's a world-renowned theologian, professor at Boston College, and we are privileged to have him with us on Monday night, so please plan on joining us. Tuesday night, we're welcoming Father Peter Joyce, pastor of Our Lady of the Assumption in Melbourne. And on Tuesday night, after he shares the theme of the mission for the night, we'll celebrate also the sacrament of reconciliation. We'll have about 10 priests available to help us celebrate this sacrament in this great and beautiful season that calls us to recall our sins and to enter more deeply into the grace and love of God. And Wednesday night, we'll close our mission that night. It starts at 6 p.m. I will welcome Father Richard Trainer, who is the minister for priests in our diocese. And at 7 p.m., everyone will be invited to join us for dinner in the parish hall. So 7 and 6 p.m. On Wednesday. If you'd like to join us for dinner on Wednesday, we do ask you to please sign up. It just helps us to make the necessary arrangements and preparation. The sign-up is located in the garden space. And there are many other wonderful things taking place in our parish. We have several information available in the garden space, so please take a look at all that information. The Women's Club is doing their 50-50, and the process of all of this will not only support their ministry, but they also are donating their profit to parish needs for our projects of evangelization. So thank you for your support. And the Knights of Columbus are also working with two parishes. They serve two parishes, St. Lee's and St. Rose of Lima. They will be having a dinner at St. Lee's, I believe it's next weekend. And all the process will help them also in their works of evangelization and charity in our local community and beyond. The Lord is with you.
With your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
Look upon those who call to you, Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death, and bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful evening. Love you all.
Thank you. As we go forth to share our love and life, please join in our closing hymn, singing our closing hymn, number 492, Jerusalem, My Destiny. 492.